My name is Michael Fausten. I'm responsible for urban automated driving at Bosch. Hey, good morning, Alexandra.
Good morning,
Michael.
How
are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you. Thanks for picking me up. Let's go to the airport then.
Let's go. Michael, what fascinates you about the topic of automated driving?
One is the safety aspects. We can train automated cars to drive very, very safely. More than 90% of all accidents are caused by human failures, and if we do a good job, automated cars will do not commit these failures. Second is ecological driving. We have to train people to drive ecologically. Automated cars, we can just program them in a way that they would do that in a way which is very ecologically friendly. Traffic is a problem. We can drive way more smoothly so that we would avoid traffic jams. And there is an aspect about democratization of mobility as well, because there's people getting older. Probably one day you would as well need to drop your driver's license. And how great would it be if you just could call an autonomous vehicle to pick you up and take you from A to B to still see your friends instead of being at home? This is the societal side of what fascinates me. And on the technical side, it is a complete new technology. It's a revolution of whatever we have been doing in automotive industry.
In regard to technology, where do we stand today and what specific challenges are there in a city like this?
Well, take a look around. You have many cars driving in different directions. You have scooters, you have bicycles, you have people. So there is a way more variety of situations and traffic participants in the cities than you have on highways. We have teamed up with Daimler in order to really provide the technology for bringing autonomous cars onto the road. Basically, the idea is to have cars which drive through the city, full city traffic, and would transport people from any pickup place to any place they want to go.
And how do different working cultures come together in such a project?
Obviously, each company has different cultures, but I think we came together because we felt from the very beginning that we have a very same understanding on safety and reliability and the quality that our products need to fulfill. So both are very keen on whatever we do will be safe, will be reliable, and you can really use it with all peace of mind in everyday's life. And this is a very, very basic common understanding that you do need in order to take the right decisions throughout the engineering process.
How do you test safety? How do you know when your automated taxi is safe enough for the road?
You do not only test safety, you design safety. That means that from the very beginning you ask yourself in your system design, what could go wrong? Your assumption is that the sensor will work properly, that your computer, the control unit, will work properly. But designing safety means you ask always, and if not, what will I do if something fails? What will I do if something unforeseeable happens? And then you design into the system something that makes sure, some mechanism that makes sure that whatever happens will not lead to a safety critical event. And then at the end you can test that you really executed what you meant to do.
Bosch and Daimler recently received the world's first approval for automated valet parking,
Yes. Which
means that both partners have already mastered the first level 4 challenge. What does this mean for other goals, for example, for your project?
Well, yes, absolutely. We had the Daimler Mercedes-Benz museum's parking lot, where we have first released a level 4 autonomous parking technology, which means that you can drop your car at the entrance of this parking lot. It will be maneuvered by itself to the parking lot, whereas you can go already into the museum. First time ever we could prove that we can manage technology and the safety aspects of such a functionality, which is surely very interesting for the user. We will take whatever we have learned in this area and bring it as well into driving on public roads. There's one major difference. We can strongly rely on the infrastructure of the parking lot here in this place. And this is something we cannot do as we drive just on the roads. And this is the next step we have to take.
Michael, thank you very much for carpooling with me. It was very interesting.
Thank you, Alexandra, for the very nice ride and the very nice talk. Hope to see you soon. Enjoy your day.